Before the opening bell, U.S. indices closed mixed on Monday. Shares in semiconductors and semiconductor equipment, tech hardware and equipment, and bank sectors ended on the negative note, while shares in consumer durables and apparel, retail, and automobiles and components, they closed in the green. On the economic front, Chicago Fed National Activity Index decreasing 2.29 in February from 0.25 in January. Also, the Dallas Fed Manufacturing Activity Index declining to 8.3 in March, all while 49% of S&P 500 constituents, they traded lower yesterday. Now, after the markets closed, McDonald's announcing the acquisition of Dynamic Yield, a personalization and decision logic tech firm, for an undisclosed fee. The company said this will enable McDonald's to be one of the first companies to integrate decision technology into the customer point of sale at a brick-and-mortar location. Meanwhile, turning overseas, Asian markets mixed today. The Nikkei up 2.15%, the Hang Seng up 0.15%, China CSI 300 down 1.13%, South Korea's KOSPI up 0.18%. European markets trading higher, and U.S. futures calling for a positive start. In terms of expectations today, Carnival Cruise Line's first quarter EPS seen at 44 cents, IHS Market first quarter EPS at 57 cents, McCormick first quarter EPS at $1.04. In terms of economic data today on the docket, 8:30 in the morning, we have the February building permits read, as well as housing starts. 9 o'clock in the morning, we have the January Housing Price Index and Case-Shiller Home Price Index. 10 o'clock in the morning, the Richmond Fed Manufacturing Index and consumer confidence for the month of March. Meanwhile, in the markets, the S&P 500 is where we begin. That sees a rebound expected, and that's in focus. The Relative Strength Index advocates for further advance. Long positions above 2790 are favored, with targets at 2828.50 and 2846 in extension. The Nasdaq, that sees the bias remain bullish, while the Dow Jones sees a move towards 25,915.